मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज पानु प्रसाद वर्किंग एज असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग इन एमवीआर कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग एंड टेक्नोलॉजी। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ यूसीएमडी। सो बिफोर वी वांट टू नो द इंट्रोडक्शन, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू नो द क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ मशीनिंग प्रोसेस। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, व्हाट इज अ मशीन? व्हाट इज अ मशीन? मशीन इज यूज्ड टू रिमूव द मटेरियल फ्रॉम द वर्कपीस इज नोन एज द मशीन। So any one type of machine are used to remove the material from the workpiece is known as the, or we can call as the machining. So machining is generally we have the few types of classifications here. The first one is conventional machining process. Second one is abrasive machining process. Third one is non-traditional machining process, or we can call as unconventional machining process. This one. So these are the machining classifications. So any one machine are used to remove the material from the workpiece is known as the machining. So in machining we have the three type of classifications. The first one is conventional machining process, or we can call as traditional machining process. So what are the examples of the conventional machining process or traditional machining process means? So see here, turning, drilling, milling, broaching, shaping, planing, boring. So these are the lathe machines. So these are the one of the examples of the conventional machining machines or traditional machining process one. So the second one is abrasive machining process one. So in abrasive machining process, what are the examples means here? Grinding, lapping, honing. So these are the examples of the abrasive machining process. It comes to these two classifications. Already we will study about MCMD. MCMT, metal cutting and machine process. So these two topics you have studied about the MCMT. Comes to the third classifications. Third classifications is nothing but here non-traditional machining process, or we can call as the unconventional machining process. So these third classifications is we are studying about the UCMB. So these are the basics of the UCMB. So what is the non-traditional machining process? Unconventional machining process, it is the one of the classification of the machining process. So it is related to the machining process. So it is the introduction. So first of all, we can start for topic here, non-traditional machining process, or we can call as the unconventional machining process. So see here, go for what is UCMD. So an unconventional machining process can be defined as a material removal process. So it is also one of the non-traditional process, or we can call as unconventional machining process. So these processes are used to remove the material. So in which no direct contact between the tool and the workpiece occurs. So in this process one, so there is no direct contact between the tool and the workpiece. So there is no physical contact between the tool and workpiece. So next one, in this type of machining process, a form of energy is used to remove the unwanted material from the given workpiece. So in this machining process, so a form of energy is used to remove the material from the workpiece. So unwanted energy is not a form of energy means here. So see here, unconventional machining process, we have the some of the classifications here. So mechanical, electrochemical, thermal, chemical. So these are the energies. By using these energies are used to remove the material from the workpiece is known as the unconventional machining process. So unconventional machining process is one of the material removal process one. So next one is there is no physical contact between the workpiece and the tool one. Next one is a form of energy are used to remove the material from the workpiece. So a form of energy means these kind of energies: mechanical energy, electrochemical energy, thermal energy, chemical energy. These energies are used to remove the material from the workpiece is known as the non-traditional machining process, or we can call as the unconventional machining process. Okay, ma, comes to here first these two classifications. So we can use the these two metals. It is also MCMT related topics. So these two also conventional machining process also. It is one of the traditional machining process. So a physical contact between the workpiece and the tool, it is also one of the metal removal process. A physical contact between the workpiece and the tool. So a tool is used to remove the from the material from the workpiece is known as the conventional machining process. So conventional machining process is a one of the metal removal process. So next one is a physical contact between the tool and the workpiece. So a machine tool is used to remove the metal from the workpiece is known as the conventional machining process. Okay, so it is a non-conventional one, it is a conventional one. So see here another one. So conventional machining process involves direct contact of the tool and the workpiece one, whereas unconventional machining process does not require the direct contact of the tool and the workpiece one. So a conventional machining process has mainly disadvantages like tool wear, so which are not present in the non-conventional machining process. So it is the basics of the, it is the definition of the conventional machining process or non-conventional machining process. So conventional machining process, it is already completed study topic one. So non-conventional machining processes we are studying in this UCMP topic one. So what are the topics we have in this UCMP means majorly? So we have the four types of classifications. First one is mechanical energy, electrochemical energy, thermal energy, chemical energy. So these energies classifications our total unit sum. These are our total introduction of the UCMP. So the non-traditional machining process or we can call as the non-conventional machining process. So in this total subject one, what kind of topics you want to discuss, what type of topics you want to know means these kind of topics you know easily. So what is the mechanical energy, classifications of mechanical energy. Next one is electrochemical energy, classifications of electrochemical energy. Next one is thermal energy, what is thermal energy and classifications of thermal energy. Next one is what is chemical energy and classifications of chemical energy. So these topics you study about the UCMP. These are overall our syllabus one, 6-unit syllabus one, these five topics, these 1, 2, 3, 4 topics one. So next one is why UCMP need. So what is the need of UCMP? So a machine produced finished product with a high degree of accuracy. So when we want to use the machining process, so and remove the material from the workpiece, so the final object we can get, the produced finished product, we can get high degree of accuracy. We can get the high degree of accuracy. So that's why it is the need for the UCMP. Next one is conventional machining process. It utilizes the cutting tools. So machine should, so we cannot use the energy here. Conventional machining process. You can utilize the tool. After then only you can remove the material from the workpiece. So see here, harder than the workpiece material. So harder than the tool is harder than the workpiece material. So next one is needs a contact between the tool and the workpiece one. So next one is need a relative motion between the tool and the workpiece one. So it is a physical contact between the tool and the workpiece. Here we are using the tool. Machine should there contact between the tool and the workpiece. After then only we can remove the material from the workpiece. How means some example one, drilling. Take the drilling. Drilling bit, it is machine should contact the tool one. After then only it remove the material one. After then only it hold the it drill and get the one hole one. That is one of the examples one. So next one is relative motion is very important. Needs a relative motion between the tool and the workpiece. Why? Because based on the motion only, it removes the material from the workpiece. So cutting machine should, we want to know the motion. Motion only, after that only grinding. Motion only, it removes the material one. So it is the needs for UCMP. So next one is we will discuss about next topic is requirement. So the requirement that lead to the development of non-traditional machining process. So what are the requirements means, see here, very high hardness and strength of the material one. So here we can see requirement means very high hardness and strength of the material we can see here. So next one is the workpiece. The tool flexible or slender to support the cutting or grinding forces one. So the workpiece machine should, it is flexible workpiece you can choose, or slender to support the cutting one or grinding forces one. So that is the workpiece function one. So the shape of the part is complex. So here unconventional machining process machine should, so we are used for the complex shapes or some difficult shapes. So use it to we want to cut here, or we want to design here, we want to manufacture in this UCMP. So the shape of the pond is complex, such as internal and external profiles or small diameter holes. So this kind of process can use the UCMP. Surface finish or tolerance better than those obtained conventional machining process. Surface finishing or tolerance are better than the conventional machining process. In UCMP, we can get more surface finish, good surface finish, good tolerances compared to conventional machining process. So next one is temperature rise or residual stress in the workpiece are undesirable. When the temperature rise, so the stress in the workpiece are undesirable. So these are the requirements that lead to the development of non-traditional machining process. Based on the requirement onwards, you can see development of non-traditional machining process. How can we develop, how can we improve this kind of non-traditional machining process or unconventional machining process? These are the main reasons. So next one is classifications. So see here, classifications of machining process. So it is based on the energy. So we have the some of the classifications. So see here, some of the classifications is nothing but here, based on the energy, we have the five types of classifications. The first one is thermal, electrical, electrochemical, chemical, mechanical. So unconventional machining process based on the energy, these are the classifications, five type of classifications. So next one is, we can see here, unconventional machining process based on the mechanism. So in this energy one, machine should we can use this mechanism. So this mechanism used only we can cut the workpiece. So what are the mechanism means? Erosion. Erosion means what type of mechanical energy in this work. So erosion are used to remove the material from the workpiece. Next one is ionic dissolution one. Dissolutions machine should we can use it for chemical one. So next one is vaporizer one. Vaporizer is nothing but here chemical one. So this type of mechanisms are used to remove the material from the workpiece. So next we can see another classifications also. So based on the energy used for removal. Based on the energy we can use it for removal one. So see here some classifications. High static pressure we can use it. High current density we can use it. High voltage we can use it. Ionized material we can use it. So these kind of materials are used to remove the material from the workpiece. So it is a classification. So it is based on the energy used to remove one. So these energy are used to remove one. These four type of energies. So here the first one is based on the mechanism. Based on the mechanism is the classifications one. This one is so first one is based on the energy one. So based on the energy, these are the classifications one. Second one is based on the mechanism, these are the classifications one. Next one is based on the energy used for removal one, these are the classifications one. So next one is, we can see here, based on the transfer of energy, the energy will be transferred from between the workpiece and the tool here. So electrically is nothing but tool, we cannot use it here. Energy only we can use it here. So see here, unconventional machining process based on the transfer of energy. So electron, first one is electron, electrolyte, high voltage particles. Next one is hot gases. So these kind of transfer of energy we can use it in the working process. So use it in the workpiece somehow. So it is a energy only here, unconventional machining process. One type of energy are used to remove the material from the workpiece, but conventional machining process, a tool are used to remove the material from the workpiece. That is a major difference. So see here carefully, conventional, non-conventional one, traditional, non-traditional one. So conventional, traditional process, a machine tool is used to remove the material from the workpiece, but comes to here unconventional or non-traditional process, a form of energy is used to remove the material from the workpiece. It's known as the non-conventional machining process, or we can call it as the non-traditional machining process. So next one is, these are the classifications, some of four types of classifications based on the energy. Based on the energy. Next one is based on mechanism. So next one is based on the transfer of energy. Next one is based on the energy used for removal one. So next one is the mechanical process. Mechanical based process. So what kind of process is involved in the mechanical based process means, so six types of points here, six types of process here. The first one is working principle. So that is the main important one. So next one is the equipment used. What kind of equipment we can use in the mechanical based process one. Next one is process parameters. Next one is MRR one. Next one is variation and techniques used one. Next one is applications one. So these are the classifications. These are classifications of the mechanical based process. So it is the based process, six types of process we have. These points are, these process, these points are used to cut the metal from the workpiece. So it is the mechanical based process. Next one is electrical based process. So see here, electrical based process, these are the classifications from the electrical based process. So these are the step by step process. The first one is working principle. Working principle are the very important one. Next one is equipment used. What kind of equipment are we can use it in the electrical based process one. Next one is process parameters. Parameters is nothing but dimensions. Workpiece diameters we are considering in the electrical based process. Why? Because to cut the workpiece, essentially we want to know the how much length we want to cut, how much length we want to remove the material from the workpiece means essentially you know the process parameters one. Next one is surface finished or MRR one. Next one is electrode tool one. Next one is power or control units one. Next one is tool wear one. Next one is dielectric one. Next one is a flushing one. Last one is applications. So these are the electrical based process classifications, not for sorry electrical based process somehow. So next one is, first one is mechanical, electrical. Next one is chemical and electrochemical based process. So see here, chemical and electrochemical based classifications in this one. So next one is, these are the process. The first one is working principles, enzymes, maskets. Next one is techniques of applying maskets. Next one is process parameters, surface finishing or MRR one. Electrical circuits in case of ECM one. This one is applications. So these are the processes. These are the electrical and chemical based process. By using this process only, we can remove the metal from the workpiece. So these are the very, very important procedures. You want to know the, these kind of procedures. After that only, we can remove the metal from the workpiece. So based on the four types of energies we have. First one is mechanical, electrical, chemical, electrochemical. Next one is thermal. Last one is last but not least, thermal based process. So in thermal based process, these are the classifications. So LBM, PIM, EBM. These are the classifications one. So see here, it is the based process. Some thermal based process means we have the five types of steps here. The first one is working principle one. Second one is equipment user one. Third one is types. What are the types? Next one is beam control techniques one. Fifth one is applications. So these are the thermal based process steps one. So these are four types of classifications. Mechanical process, this one. So next one is the mechanical based process. We have the steps one. So next one is electrical based process. This is a procedure one. So next one is thermal based process. These are the procedure one. Next one is chemical and electro. Chemical based procedure. So these are the steps. So these are the, our total entire syllabus. So mechanical one, mechanical process you want to study, electrical based process you want to study, chemical one, and next one is thermal one. Thermal one you want to study these kind of topics in UCMB. Next one is, what is the selection process? First one. So what is the selection? How can we select the material? How can you select the energy? How can you select the mechanisms? So these are steps. First of all, physical parameters. Selection process is based on the following parameters. The first one is physical parameters. Second one is shape to be machined. Physical parameters is very important. So based on the dimensions. So here we want to remove the material from the workpiece. So how much we want to remove the material? How much depth you want to hold the workpiece one. So these kind of parameters essentially we want to know before select the procedure, before select the energy, before select the procedure, before select the mechanism, essentially we want to know this kind of information. So physical parameters, first one is, next one is shape to be machined. So what kind of shape you want to machine it. So that is a very important one. Next one is process capability. How much capability about the total two is there one. Next one is economic consideration. So what is the economic consideration one? We want to remove the metal. What is the economic one? How much cost? Everything is you want to know before selection process. These are the selection process based on the parameters somehow. So physical parameters, shape to be machined, process capability, economic consideration one. So next one is we can see advantages of non-conventional machining process. So this is our topics and basics work. So this in previous one we want to know the about basics. What is the machine and classifications of machining process. Next one, what is UCMP? What are the classifications of UCMP we have? So what is the procedures we have? So next one is what is the selection process? The final one is advantages of non-conventional machining process. So what are the major advantages means by using the UCMP, by using the non-traditional machining process? The first one is high accuracy and surface finishing one. You can get high accuracy, good high accuracy you can get and good surface you can get in UCMP or non-traditional machining process or non-conventional machining process. So next one is less by know where we can get in non-conventional machining process one. Tool life is more one. Here the tool life is more. That is one of the advantages one. They quicker operations, quieter operations. So different types of operations we can see in the non-conventional machining process. So these are the advantages of the some of the advantages of the non-conventional machining process. So what are the disadvantages? So see here it is advantages one. This one is we have some of the disadvantages. So high cost. So unconventional machining process or high cost machining process one. Next one is complex setup. Complex setup is very difficult one. Next one is skilled operator is required one. So the common man cannot operate the UCMP machining process one. Why? Because the skilled operator is very important one. A skilled operator is very required one. After that only we can get the exact shape of the material one. So after that we cannot get the good accuracy, good surface finish, everything is so unsatisfaction material one we can get. So that is a disadvantage of the non-conventional machining process. Next one is so it is our total topics one here. So so see here once again. First of all is today our topic is the introduction. So already introduction is completed. Again I am repeating the introduction. Why? Because mostly students are absent in the regular class time, some regular working days. So many students are absent, so they cannot listen the introduction one. So that's why once again I am repeating the introduction one. So the first one is what is machining process and the classification of machining process here. The first two classifications is already you learn about the MCMT work. That third classification is nothing but here UCMP or we can call as non-traditional machining process. So in this UCMP, what kind of topic you want to know means. So see here mechanical energy. So these are the energies. So these are the energies you want to study here by using these energies or remove the metal from the workpiece. So the first two classifications onwards, you can use the tool. By using the tool only we can remove the metal from the workpiece, but here a form of energy are used to remove the metal from the workpiece in non-traditional machining process or unconventional machining process. So these are the very important classifications. After then only we can start the our syllabus one, our topic one. So what is the UCMP one? Next one is what is conventional machining process one. Next one is what is the need of UCMP one. Next one is what is the requirement to lead to develop the non-traditional machining process one. Next one is your classifications. Classifications is nothing but based on the energy. So these are the classification one. Based on the mechanism, these are the classification one. Next one is based on the energy used to removal one, classification one. Next one is based on the transfer of energy. These are the classifications one. So next one is based process, mechanical based process. What are the process? What are the steps is involved in the mechanical based process? Means these are the steps one. So next one is electrical one. So next one is chemical, electrochemical one. Next one is thermal based process one. So next one is what is the selection process? So selection process is based on the following parameters. Some of these parameters were selection process one. So next one is the advantages of non-conventional machining process. Next one is disadvantages of non-conventional machining processing. So it is today topic one. Next one is we have the one topic, that is the applications. What are the applications of the and UCMD? So this is our total introduction one, introduction and the topics also. So next one we will discuss about. So see here, let's see how it is our syllabus one, unconventional machining process. The first unit is one, introduction. So today we will discuss about the introduction one, total one, needs for non-traditional machining processes completed, method and classifications of modern machining processes completed one, consideration in process selection process. Next one is applications is pending for the introduction topic one. So next tomorrow class we will discuss about what are the applications of the UCMP one. Next class is ultrasonic machining, we will start for next class one. So these are the our total syllabus, 6 units one. So it is the first unit, second unit is electrochemical machining amma. So the introduction one, the introduction, these total topics also, the ultrasonic machining is one of the mechanical energy amma. So this ultrasonic machining is one of the mechanical energy. So it is the first unit one. Second unit is electrochemical energy. Completely it is the chemical energy. Based on the chemical energy classifications in the second unit one, totally you know the electrochemical machining process. So introduction one, classifications one, application one. So advantages, disadvantages, totally you learn about the electrochemical machining process. The third one is thermal metal removal process. So first one is mechanical one, electrochemical energy process one, this one is thermal one. Third ending is thermal metal removal process. So in thermal energy are used to remove the metal from the workpiece here. Third unit and fourth unit and fifth unit also, these three units is thermal energy, thermal related topics. Thermal energy are used to remove the metal from the workpiece is known as the thermal metal removal process. So here electrochemical process. The electrochemical process is what happened? A form of chemical energy are used to, electrochemical energy are used to remove the metal from the workpiece is known as the electrochemical energy. So next one is mechanical. A form of mechanical energy are used to remove the metal from the workpiece. So this is the topic. First one is mechanical one, electrochemical one. Third one is thermal one. Thermal means we have the three topics one. Thermal one, third, fourth, fifth, last unit also we have, that is abrasive jet machining process, water jet machining process. The sixth unit also related to the mechanical energy process. So the sixth unit also, first and sixth are mechanical energy related topics one. Second unit is electrochemical energy related topics. Third, fourth, fifth, these three units are thermal related energy process. So it is our total syllabus. So it is our today class one. Okay, so if you have any doubts regarding these topics, so please contact me. Okay, any kind of doubts, I will clarify you. Okay, so this is our total syllabus one, very easy topics one. So very easy subject also. So the syllabus also very less syllabus. So introduction is completed today. So only application is pending here. So tomorrow class, we will discuss about ultrasonic machining one. So next one is we will discuss about, so next class we will discuss about, next topic is electrochemical machining process, thermal, three units is thermal one, last one is mechanical again. We want to study about these topics one, Amma. Thank you, Amma. So mustn't should all of you attend the classes, Amma, and give your attendance on comment box one. It is very serious one. So mustn't should all of you attend the, or అలా మీరు కంపల్సరిగా వీడియో చూడాలి. చూసిన తర్వాత మీరు మీ అటెండెన్స్ని కామెంట్ బాక్స్లో మీ రోల్ నెంబర్తో మెసేజ్ చేయండి అమ్మా. ఓకే, సో ఇట్ ఈస్ అవర్ టుడే టాపిక్ అమ్మా. థ్యాంక్ యూ.